I am honored to ask this man to come to stage. You know him as the lead singer of August Burns Red.
Yeah.
He recently started a new ministry called Heart Support. You can catch it out at heartsupport.com. It's an online community, not unlike My Broken Palace, but basically a place for you guys to collectively give one another words of encouragement, strength, and support. Would you please welcome Jake Lewers?
Hey, how's everybody doing today? I don't have much time. I got about 15 minutes, but and then Plea for Purging is going to come up here and just wreck all of you guys' lives. So it's going to be pretty awesome. But yeah, a lot of people, a lot of you guys know me as the lead singer of August Burns Red. And honestly, it's a blessing to be in that band. All those guys are hands down just good people and have through the years really encouraged me and uplifted me whenever I was touring with them. And so it's really awesome to be a part of this and be with that band. But I Matter Fest is obviously dealing with depression and suicide and everything else. And I guess their numbers here in this state are the highest, highest ever. And so they're doing this festival to bring people together to encourage the community and the town for hope and against depression and things like that. And so I kind of just wanted to tell you a little bit of my background. And how I was at even one point suicidal. My parents are divorced, and I had a really close family member that dealt with heroin and heroin addiction for 3 years, and that was really difficult to cope with. And through the broken family and everything else, I kind of just went to drugs and alcohol and sex and all this stuff. And my passion was music, being in a band, you know, so I started music when I was like 16, 17 years old, and I started a band on my own. I sold my car and I bought a cargo van. That looked pretty sketchy. You never see anyone driving a cargo van. But I did it for my band, and I was working a couple jobs, you know. I was going to school for music, and I was really trying to live my dream and my passion. But my band ended up breaking up. My guys were just huge egos, big-headed dudes. Partying was a huge issue. You know, drugs and alcohol, whatever, girls. Like, it's just a sad situation. But once the band broke up, I really fell into depression. Coming from a broken family, I didn't really feel loved as a kid. And so I was holding all this weight, and I just kind of felt like nobody really cared and nobody really loved me. So I thought to myself, like, why is it even a point to live life? Why should I live here if my life is truly hell, you know? And I've always heard about Jesus. Like I'm sure everybody's just heard about Jesus and heard about the church. And honestly, I didn't like church at all. I thought everybody was just extremely judgmental. That's how I felt walking into a church. I always felt like they thought they were better than me. And why would they be better than me, you know? And how can you have that mentality if you serve such a loving, caring God? So I wasn't really a churchgoer. But at this point in my life, wanting to commit suicide, I thought to myself, you know what? I really don't have many other options. And so I kind of, I don't want to say I challenged God, because I don't, I mean, just thinking about challenging God just kind of creeps me and scares me out. But I went outside and I smoked a cigarette and I said, God, if you're real, if your son Jesus is real, then I want you to show me. Because if you don't want my life, if you don't care about me, then nobody does. And I have no problem killing myself right now, because there is no hell, there is no heaven, there is no God. Jesus is not Jesus, he was just a man. And so I asked for Jesus to be in my heart, and it was sincere, it was real. It was my last resort, it was all I had. And sure enough, like, right when I did that, I couldn't stop smiling. And I felt this feeling of restoration and I knew then and there that I was no longer alone. And I knew that there was God. And through this feeling, I mean, it can't really express it, but through this feeling, I knew that Jesus was real, because I asked for him. I said, if you're real, come to me. And sure enough, like, I was in the same situation. I was still dealing with alcohol. I was still dealing with pornography. I was still dealing with the fact that, you know, I was getting hammered all the time, trying to, you know, mess around with any girls, that, you know, the whole party thing. I still felt like I had, you know, I was a painter, so I was still painting. I had all these things in my life that were still there, but I knew that God was going to change my life, and I knew that he did care and that he does love me. And shortly after that, I got an opportunity to tour with August Burns Red. Brent Rambler calls me. He's like, hey, is Jake there? I'm like, yeah. He's like, this is Brent from August Burns Red. I was like, hold on. I had to go to a certain place. I was at work, you know, and I'm like, yeah. He's like, yeah, we want you to try out. I was like, okay, that's cool. Today's Friday. Tell you what, how about next week? He's like, no, we want you to come Monday. I was like, Monday? I was like, I got a job. But I knew that this was an opportunity, and I felt that it was a door that God had put into my vision. And I feel like a lot of people, they wanna pray to God and say, oh God, you know, like, please, you know, work this out for me. And then God gives us all these opportunities, and we don't walk through the door. We don't make the sacrifice to actually go through with it. And God led me to this opportunity, and I said, okay. So I quit my job that day. I threw all my stuff in an 88 Honda hatchback Civic. I drove 13 hours from South Carolina to Pennsylvania. I tried out. I toured with them for 6 months straight, never going home. And then I have been touring for 6 years with this band. And you know what? But that to me is proof that God is real. He took me when I wanted to take my own life. And he said, you know what, Jake? Give it to me. Let me have, let me take charge of your life. Let me do this for you, you know? If you will submit your heart and just give it to me, I will lead you in the right direction, and I will bring you up, and I'll teach you, and I'll love you. And love is God. God is love. That's what I've understood. I've never felt love from anyone on this earth like I've felt love from God and from Jesus. And you know what? I thought that it was, you know, people that talk about Jesus and everything, my mind view on, you know, people that throw his name around and everything else was like, ugh, like, stop being this croy ultra-Christian person that's trying to push a religion down my throat. I hate you. I hate religion. But that's not what I'm here talking about right now. I'm talking about a real relationship with Jesus. I'm talking about praying to God, communicating to your Creator. On a daily basis as to how you want to live your life. What do you want? What are your desires and dreams? Well, go out and get it, because God is going to lead you there. You know, God does not give us the desires of our heart just for us to lay our heads down at night and go to sleep dreaming about them. He gives us the desires of our heart to reach out and go for it. Go for it. Anything is possible, especially when you're walking with God, your Creator. That's what we were created to do. God gave us life as a gift. What did he ask? That we walk with him. And if you walk with God, he's going to put you on a right path. And so I've got 2 minutes left. I have to cut short. I just want to encourage everybody here that, you know what? There are struggles. There are things you're going to go through. There are going to be times when you just want to give up. But you know what? I want you to think to yourself and think, you know what? Give it to God and see what God does with your life. Really open yourself up in your heart to Jesus Christ and have a relationship and see what happens. Not a religion, a relationship. Thank you guys so much. God bless every single one of you. Right now, Plea for Prayer Team is going to kill it. Thank you guys.